Welcome back to Forex Pros. Today we will be doing a multi-time frame analysis on USDJPY and see what kind of trading opportunities can we find. I will try to make this analysis as educational as possible so that you can use this strategy to analyze any pair in the market. Now, starting from the monthly time frame, what we can see is that the market has broken a very important structural resistance, which was effective at this point, again effective at this point, and twice more effective at these points. Now, what we can see is that the market has now broken above the structural resistance, and this important structural resistance is now the structural support. So after the retest, we can expect the market to continue its movement towards the upside. So the market is bullish on the monthly time frame. Moving down to the weekly time frame, what we can see is that the market last week candle was with a big wick, and after this kind of candle, what do we expect? We expect the market to continue its movement towards the upside. Again, moving down to the daily time frame, what we can see is that a basic pattern which we have discussed multiple times is the W pattern. And after the W pattern, what do we expect? We expect a retracement to the bottom neckline before the continuation towards the upside. So on the daily time frame, what will be strategy of for our next week? So what we can see is that basically we will be waiting for the market to basically shift its momentum towards the downside on the 4-hour chart, and we can have a small shorting opportunity on the 4-hour chart time frame. We will also post a signal in our free Telegram channel. The link is in the description. So let's hope that the market shifts its momentum towards the downside. Otherwise, there is a possibility that the market may continue its upward movement. Now, as we know, there are two types of trading strategies. One is reactive and second is predictive. So basically, we will not be entering shorting the market on the basis of the prediction that the market will go towards the downside. We will wait and see what the market does, and we will act accordingly. That is being reactive, not predictive. If you liked our analysis, do like the video and tell us in the comment section which pair or topic would you like us to analyze in the next video.